Hi babes, it's Val here, and in today's video we are talking all about my favorite moisturizers. But hey, if you're new to my channel, my name is Val, and here I try to give you some simple tips and tricks on how you can look and feel better. As well as this, I do review some products so you know if it's worth buying them or not. So without any further ado, let's go into moisturizers. Now, just a quick disclaimer, I have combination to oily skin. My T-zone is quite oily really. So all of the skincare which I use is aimed to this skin group. Now, something else quickly, I'm not a skin expert in any way. So everything I know is based on research which I've done for quite a long time really. I always had problematic skin, and that was one of the reasons that I was researching skincare. Is there any way to calm down my skin a little bit, to, you know, just reduce the amount of blackheads and whiteheads constantly coming on my face? Skincare is never able to do what injectables can do for you, what surgery can do for you, or what lasers can do for you. Bear that in mind when you spend a lot of money on skincare. You might as well spend them on one of the other procedures. So let's start with the moisturizers. What I'm looking for in a moisturizer. Now, first off, I see many people don't know that the moisturizers don't actually put back moisture in your skin. What moisturizer is doing is preventing transepidermal water loss. I know you can read, you know, like you read in hyaluronic acid and etc. etc. First off, hyaluronic acid is not able, it doesn't matter how small molecules are, won't be able in any way to pass the membranes of your skin and go into the deeper layers of your skin. Now, I divide moisturizers in two categories. First off, plain moisturizers, which help reducing the water loss from my skin. And then the second category are moisturizers which contain active ingredients. That being said, I guess you already know that if you ask me would I spend a lot of money on just a plain moisturizer which doesn't contain any active ingredients, the answer is no, I won't. Now, if you want to spend your money on something more expensive just because something is a name, it's a brand, it's marketing, that's only up to you. The main difference between expensive moisturizers and cheap moisturizers is the first ones are obviously more cosmetically elegant, meaning that they sit and they feel better on your skin. And second, the only thing you might find, I say might find, in a little bit more expensive moisturizer is some ingredients, like some certain plant ingredients, which help better preventing that water loss from your skin. All of these ingredients, which are antioxidants and etc., they might help your skin in general, creating that barrier against pollution and etc., but none of them will go deep in your skin and work a miracle, if you're looking for one. I'm just saying. And then the other category moisturizers which I use are the ones with active ingredients. Now, obviously, next question is which are active ingredients I use. Vitamin A, aka retinoic acid, vitamin B, mainly vitamin B3, niacinamide, and vitamin C, aka L-ascorbic acid. So these are the three active ingredients which actually do something for your skin in that sense. Especially when they're combined together in the right proper skincare routine, then you can really see some difference in your skin. For people with acne and acne prone skin, vitamin A is the one and only thing still proven to work. So I know that's a little bit overwhelming and a little bit of long info, let's say, and I hope you're not really bored so far, but for me it's impossible to just show you this and that moisturizer and, you know, like I like this and I don't like that. I really want to give you a reason why would I use a certain product. In other words, I wouldn't spend any money on a product if I don't know why I'm buying it. Something which I don't use in my skincare is mineral oil. The other thing I really try to avoid in my skincare is alcohols, the drying alcohols. I mean, if it does contain some alcohols or fragrance, I really want to see them in the end of the ingredient list. Other products which contain alcohol but I still use are sunscreens, and especially Korean sunscreens. All of them contain alcohol, unfortunately, but that's why they're so cosmetically elegant. With that being said, I need my moisturizer to work well with my sunscreen. So let's start with the sunscreen. My favorite sunscreen is this one, and this is Biore Aqua Rich Watery Gel SPF 50 PA++++. If you have oily skin, this sunscreen, believe me or no, will change your life. The next one which I'm using right now is Etude House Sun Prize. It's mild airy finish SPF 50 PA++++. This is the sunscreen. I definitely like this one more than the Etude House one. Then I will start with the plain moisturizers. I will start off with the cheapest one, I believe. I think that's the cheapest one of all. That's Biotin. I think it's pronounced Skin Moisture. It's the one with the blue cup. To be honest with you, I'm not very familiar with this brand, but a friend of mine bought this moisturizer. I just tried it since she was staying in my house and I liked it. Now, since summer is coming, I prefer to use this one at night. Next up, I have the one which I'm loving really from La Roche-Posay. This, I'm using it even now. All of the time, it's almost gone though, so I need to get another one once some of the other ones is finished at least. Anyway, this is Pigmenta Clar. It's UV SPF 30, contains an active ingredient, and it's a fiery succinol. This is used for hyperpigmentation. I have hyperpigmentation on my upper lip. It sits really nice under makeup. It gives you that nice glow, but no oiliness on your skin. Next up, we have one of my other favorites. Right now, I'm using this one or the Pigmenta Clar, again from La Roche-Posay. It's just one of the brands which I think you can't really go wrong with them. That's what I like about them. So that's the Hydro Face. That's Intense Legere. This contains hyaluronic acid as well. Next up, we have something else which I like. This is Clinique Moisture Surge 72-hour auto-replenishing hydrator, a long name. Honestly, from Clinique, my favorite is this one. That's the Supercharged Concentrate, but unfortunately I didn't keep the bottle. So this one is a tad bit more sticky for me. We are going to the ones which contain more active ingredients. Number one, as I told you before, skincare active ingredient for oily skin type like mine is retinoic acid. This is Adaferin. It's a gel formula, and the active ingredient in this one is Adapalene. It's the gold standard for acne prone skin. It's the gold standard for blackheads, whiteheads. Next thing, oh, I missed that. That's going in the part of just general moisturizers, simple moisturizers. That's one of my favorites as well. Especially winter time. Summertime I would use it more nighttime when I want something plain, simple. And this is the Ordinary Natural Moisturizing Factors Plus HA, which stands for hyaluronic acid. Next one, we are going for vitamin C, and this is the Ordinary again, the CM. Now, L-ascorbic acid is the one active form of vitamin C which straight penetrates your skin. So since this is a silicone base and it's quite high concentration of vitamin C, the thickness of the product doesn't really... I really don't like to use it daytime. Some people do. I prefer using it nighttime. It definitely gives you tingles. Next up, we have something really nice. Estee Lauder Serum. This is my miniature version. It's Advanced Night Repair Serum. One of the most famous serums in the world. So something with similar results is the Ordinary. This is the Buffett serum. Now, this contains peptides and it's nice for me. I like to use this one nighttime. It's just a little bit too thick for me, so I don't like it under makeup and I prefer using it at night. Next, we have something which I really like as well, especially for summertime. I can straight use only this and then my sunscreen and I'm fine. This is the Marine Hyaluronics from The Ordinary again. So that's a nice one when you really don't want to layer skincare and you just want to use this and your sunscreen and you're good to go. Next up, we have something again from The Ordinary. This is Salicylic Acid 2% and this is BHA. If you don't know what is salicylic acid, this acid is lipophilic, which means that it likes oil. So what it's doing for your skin is just going like a small brush in your pores and it's cleaning that dirt out and helps you to clear your face from blackheads and whiteheads and etc. So the next one, guys, is another serum, and it's niacinamide 10% plus zinc 1%. It's by The Ordinary again. As I told you, I like the brand generally. It's really affordable, so why not? Now, niacinamide, it's the one ingredient which, first off, is anti-inflammatory. Second of all, it helps oiliness. It reduces the oiliness in your skin. And most importantly for me, it helps vitamin A penetrate your skin better. It just calms down the irritation which vitamin A gives you. So hand in hand, both of these work magic together. This one here is prescription strength tretinoin or retinoic acid. This is the first generation of retinoic acid. Now the concentration which I use is 0.03%. This is in cream form and I use it only at night. Then something which I really like from Avon. This is a new reversalist, Infinite Effects. This is double-sided moisturizer. And the purpose of this is to avoid that plateau effect on your skin when you get used with certain skin active ingredient and you stop seeing the result as good as in the beginning. This is step one. You use this step one for 1 week, which is just a plain moisturizer enriched with some skincare ingredients to help prepare your skin for the next step, which is step two. This is this side, and this one contains a form of retinol, again of retinoic acid. Last but not least, that's a nice one, a tiny baby here. I got it in the set with this gel cream from Clinique, present from my sister. Now this is just a hyaluronic acid based spray. Something which I really wanted to mention, it's last but not least, I don't have the bottle right now with me. This is a Vichy Mineral 89. That's a serum. It's hyaluronic acid-based serum and it's really lightweight. That was one of my favorite things last summer. I was using it constantly every day. I was using just this serum and sunscreen on the top. And guys, that was all for today's video. I hope you found it helpful. And if you did, please give me thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and ring the bell below so you don't miss any of the upcoming videos on skincare, lifestyle, makeup and all of that jazz. And guys, I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye!